she will never lose me. The show started with their true love waking her up, and we felt like this is the natural evolution of everything they've ever come to. Think of a baby, think of being a mother.
All I could think about when watching that was that I was super pregnant.
You're all in a restaurant and women's luck. And that baby's face.
I recall that there was a genuine tears problem. I kept losing it. I've loved you.
Personally, I think we responded to it, and I think fans responded to it as well.
If you split my heart in half, we can both survive.
The same romance of this great love come together.
It doesn't surprise me at all that Snow and Charming share a physical heart. It actually made a lot of their story fall into place.
What does it mean to be doing a show that puts such an emphasis on hope and belief?
I think that's a lovely thing, actually. It's one of the nicest things about the show.
I love that the show is about hope and belief.
I think that it's something that's pretty rare nowadays on TV.
What are fairy tales for?
And what exactly do you think fairy tales are? Just to see people's reaction, that it does bring some hope to people's lives, and it does brighten their day a little bit.
They are a reminder that our lives could get better if we just hold on to hope.
Nice to be a part of a show that translates that way to an audience.
Look, I gave the book to him because I wanted him to have the most important thing anyone can have.
That's one of the main reasons why the show is so successful.
Believing in the possibility of a happy ending was a very powerful thing.
And why it strikes a chord with so many people.
We've always worked out. You know what? Just we have hope.
I don't know the last time I saw a television show based on such a beautiful, magical, and attainable value.
You get a quarter from the location every time you say that word, every minute.
That's what everyone needs in the world, is having a bit of faith in something.
Our show is a great representation of that.
Sooner or later, your heart will find its way to happiness.
That doesn't feel possible.
There's a moral lesson to learn at the end of every episode. I've seen a lot of our fans respond to that.
You feel things with your whole soul. Don't let anything hold you back.
How do you feel about playing such a strong female character?
It's always amazing playing a strong female.
Sometimes a hero has to sacrifice everything to save the people they love.
I feel responsible because the effect that this character has on so many makes me responsible.
No! Enough.
Somehow you're a hero.
Today I am.
Playing a strong female character is a way more important role model for young women than playing someone weak. That's what's so great about the show, is they really know how to write for women.
Out of my way, munchkin.
I'm a dwarf.
That's even worse. It's about being powerful and strong and being authentically you, whether you're a hero or a villain.
Relax.
And there's strength in that.
That pointy little hook of yours could scratch and be immortal, but me? You're out of your depth. Pirate.
It's usually a nice platform to be able to portray some awesome messages for especially our younger female audience.
There aren't a lot of opportunities for women in this land to be heroes.
That's why, you know, characters like Elsa and Anna from Frozen fit so well into the canon of Once Upon a Time.
The only way to ever truly be in control of your powers is to embrace them.
Strong female characters coming in to mix with all our characters.
It's time to stop being afraid.
And I like that the way strong women on the show are written is in a way that's very real. You know, it just because you're strong doesn't mean you're never vulnerable. I think there's a real depth of dimension to what's going on.
Storybook on vacation to, I don't know, Bahamas, Mexico.
They would go insane because, I mean, that's not something that they're used to.
Why
I think a nice picnic in the park with everybody in Storybrooke, then going bowling with the Seven Dwarfs, and then ending up in the pub.
Love the ambiance.
With the Charmings, Emma and Hook, and me and Regina.
Maybe read, go for a little walk, take a little smooch, maybe, dinner, and maybe try and get to see Back to the Future.
I think her perfect day would involve a bath. I don't think these people ever bathe.
I took a bath this morning, I swear.
They certainly don't seem to eat. I cannot tell you the relief of cooking something that I didn't have to kill first.
Don't I know it? Meatloaf back home? What a bitch. Maybe they go out on a boat? I mean, we're by the water all the time. Maybe they go out on Hook's boat?
No, I think Storybrooke needs a crisis to stay interesting.
It's really great to have those moments in finale or something where the crisis has been averted and you have a few hours just to sit back and relax in Granny's.
This is Granny's. She makes a mean lasagna and runs in here.
Party at Granny's is usually the best time because lasagna's half off.
I'm sorry, Granny. Lasagna tastes so good.
We actually very often wind up shooting Granny scenes on Friday nights.
Yeah.
And it's always fun with all your favorite characters just hanging out. It. So lasagna may be fake, but the fun's real.
Better network as explained by a high school ed couple.
Verizon's coverage of this cost.